made and God made was good. He created man on day six. And everything that God had created was made good. But sin came into the world. And see, what you don't seem to understand is that God is a God of covenant. God is a God of covenant who works with his people, who works with unbelievers in covenant. And so he creates a covenant of works with Adam in the garden, which Adam transgresses. And because Adam is our covenant head, or our federal head, we are born sinners by nature because of Adam's sin. We inherited a sinful nature by at birth because of the sin of Adam. And so because of the sin of Adam, we are all born condemned. That is why we need someone to save us from our sins. And only Christ can do that. Only Christ can save us. The one who has created all things, the one who is who created everything, and by him, for him, and through him, everything that exists, exists because of him. And God is patient. He is long-suffering. He is giving you time. He is giving you time to either repent, or he is using his word to harden your heart
you guys.
To the things of God.
I'm with
and that's
you guys.
A scary place to be.
I'm Larry.
It is a scary
I'm
place
Larry.
To be, because the Bible says it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Do you know what the Bible says in Proverbs? The book of Proverbs is a book about wisdom. It's Solomon speaking to his son and telling them, here,
yeah,
let me give you instruction, sound wisdom, sound instruction. And he says in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7, that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. But fools despise wisdom. Fools despise wisdom. And it's not calling you a fool to be derogatory to you. It's saying that it's foolish to deny the very existence of the God you already know who created you. You know God created you. You know you have this, as my brother already said, you have this law that's been written upon your heart. Romans 2 tells us that you, by being not a one under the law, do by nature what the law commands, show and testify to the truth of God. The very fact that you are rebelling against God and angry against God is testifying to the very fact that you know God exists and you know that God will hold you responsible and accountable to him on the day of judgment. And so we are here to tell you, turn to Christ. We're here to tell you to repent. Repentance is, let me explain. Yeah, does anybody know what repentance is? What does repentance mean? What does repentance mean? What does it mean? Does anybody know? Does anybody here? Is anybody here able to do? You want to ask questions. I'll entertain questions if you've got a rational and you're actually going to reason. But if you're just going to say curse words and curse and say vile things, perverted things, it's not having a dialogue. Does anybody know what repentance is? Repentance is the word metanoia. It's a change of mind. As I said, it's not something you can do in yourself. It's godly sorrow that grants repentance. It's turning from this idea of what you right now have, this idolatrous idea of God, and it's turning from this idolatrous view of God and coming into agreement with who God says he is. It's coming into agreement with who God says he is. And God says he is the creator of all things, and God says he is holy three times because he is triune by his very nature. God says that he is righteous. God says that he is just. You want to emphasize the love of God, but you can't just take the love of God and separate it from his holiness. You can't separate it from his justice and his mercy and grace. It's all God and his attributes. He is perfect in every single characteristic of God. And unless you repent, this turning from your idea of this idolatrous God, which you have in your mind right now, and coming into agreement with the true and living God, you will surely perish in your sins. And so the most loving thing that we can do, regardless of whether you believe it or not or accept it as love, the most loving thing we can do for you here today is to tell you to repent and turn to Christ and live. Because if you die in your sins, you will spend eternity in hell. That's the reality. And I'm not speaking of hell to scare you there, because I've already stated this to you. It's not by your own choice. It's not by your own will. You're not choosing God because you decide, oh, there's enough evidence for God, or this guy makes a good compelling argument. If you choose God, if you come to true faith in God, it's because he has done a work in your heart. It's because God has done a work in your heart, because you cannot do it on your own. So if anybody here has an actual question and you want to actually have a rational not. God is true, whether you want to accept it or not. As my other friend said earlier, men suppress the truth in their unrighteousness. Because you love your sin, you deny the one who has created you. That's what everybody here is doing today. That's what I did before Christ saved me. I'm going to get to your question.
I'm a confirmed Catholic.
That doesn't matter. Roman Catholicism is a false religion.
The world. want to demonstrate that by one man,
No, you gotta understand God's creation, first of all. You said something first that I want to address. You said you was a child of God. Max, let me explain something to you. And out of the love of my heart, I'm telling you this truthfully. You was never a child of God. I'm not, it's not a funny thing. The Bible says you are either a child of God or a child of Satan. The only way that someone can experience adoption, that someone can become a child of God, is through Christ.
Okay.
Do you have a respectable question? Because I'm not going to entertain it if you're going to say something perverted or cursing. I'm just not going to do it. What's your name?
Justin.
Justin, I'm with you. Can you give me a hug? I'll let you. I'm up here, but you can shake my hand. I just can't. I don't want to. Please, you come around. Any other questions? So we are continuing to proclaim the gospel because, as I said, the gospel of God is the power unto salvation to those who believe. The gospel is the power of God to those who believe. What is the gospel? I've been preaching it. I've said it already. My friends have said it. Does anybody know the gospel, or were you not paying attention? Okay, the gospel is this, that Jesus Christ came into the world living a perfect, sinless life, the creator of all things. He was born of a virgin because the sin that was inherited from Adam is passed down through the man. It's passed down through the line of men. And so that's why Jesus Christ was born of a virgin. That's why there's an importance in understanding the virgin birth. Christ was born of a virgin because it tells us in Genesis 3:15 that her seed will crush the head of the serpent. Christ is that one that came and crushed the head of the serpent when he died on the cross. And he rose again on the third day, defeating sin and death.
You don't believe that?
Defeating sin and death.
You're a liar.
And he will bring to his culmination all things which he is restoring to himself, bringing his enemies under his foot. And he's restoring all things unto himself. And that final enemy, death, will be defeated. Come to God, okay? You can't choose to come to God. We are out here because